Welcome back. Toronto, Vancouver, among the world's biggest housing bubbles. That's according to a report published by Swiss investment bank UBS. It ranked the Canadian cities in the top six for overall high housing prices. For more on this, let's bring in Tom Storey. He's a realtor with Royal LePage. He joins me today from Toronto. Welcome.
Thank you for having me on.
So are you surprised by this study? Do you agree?
I'm not surprised. I think the housing bubble narrative is one that we've heard in the past and one that we will continue to hear in the future. And, you know, the fact is that anyone saying there's a bubble, they're never wrong until it happens and then they're right. If I'm a homeowner in Toronto or Vancouver, I wouldn't be overly concerned, though.
Okay, so but why do these two cities have this problem? Popular cities, two cities that are ever growing, people looking for housing, but they can't afford it.
Yeah, it's simple supply demand. The inventory levels in both these cities historically has been very, very low. And that's why we've seen such an increase in the prices. And what this report really looked at is just how expensive, based on your average salary, it would be to buy in these cities. And I believe Vancouver was 9 times and Toronto was 6 times. And that's just for your average property. So it's understandable that these cities are getting more expensive. But in terms of a bubble actually happening, I think the core fundamentals of what moves the market are still very much in place.
Good, obviously, for those looking to sell. But how is this affecting prospective home buyers in both cities? Because, I mean, as you said, if you're looking to move there and you need a home to stay and you can't afford it, then what?
Yeah, you know what? It's anyone that says that they know what's going to happen in the future, frankly, is probably lying. But what we can do is we can track what's happened in the past in the markets. What I always break it down to is if I'm a buyer, I want to educate myself as much as I possibly can. So I want to know what's happening with these with the interest rates. Are they going to go up again before the end of the year? Just the overall immigration moving into an area. So how many people are coming in? What is the demand going to be in the future for housing? And I would also look at unemployment rates in the city I'm moving to, because if people have jobs, they're going to buy houses, and that's probably going to keep the prices going up over a steady period of time.
So is there any way to sort of balance things out? I don't want to say eliminate it, because it's probably not possible, but is there any way that things can get balanced out, that you're on sort of a more even keel when it comes to this?
Well, I think the government of Canada is trying, whether it be the foreign buyer tax to get rid of a lot of the speculation, or you have the new stress test that came at the beginning of 2018, where if the rates went up, that the average Canadian would still be able to afford their home. Mm-hmm. There's policies in place to make sure that our overall market is getting more balanced. But I think at the end of the day, for Toronto and Vancouver, the reason why they're saying there's a bubble is because people want to live in these cities. We have a great quality of life in Canada, and sometimes, you know, living here, we don't always remember that.
Is it seasonal?
I think a little bit. I mean, if you look at just average price and when the best time to buy would be in different markets, in my market in Toronto, if you track it over the past 5 years, actually buying at the end of August or in December is the best time to buy price-wise, but there's also a lot less to look at because people are at cottages or dealing with the holidays.
All right. Well, you've given us a little bit of hope, if you will. Tom Storey, realtor with Royal LePage. Royal LePage, excuse me. A pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you very much.